All right, so let's see if we can think through or maybe guess what's going to happen if TD lambda is run as an update algorithm on some finite amount of data. So we give the system some finite amount of data, and then we run TD lambda with different possible values of lambda, and then we ask, all right, the V that you've learned, how far is that from what the V should have been if we had infinite data?
Uh-huh.
All right, so let's, I don't know, let's sort of see if we can figure out or maybe even guess what this might look like. So let's say if we use lambda equals zero, so we do TD zero. So after some finite amount of data, there's going to be some amount of error. Let's just, call it that.
Okay.
Now, it turns out empirically, if you play with this, it's pretty typical for TD one to give you worse error given finite data. And now the important thing is what happens in between. So it could be like a straight line if it was literally interpolating. It could be kind of bowed up, but it's actually typically bowed down. So it's not so atypical to see a curve kind of like this that gets better. The amount of error goes down as lambda gets to some intermediate value. Let's call it, 0.7. It depends, of course, on the particular problem, and then kind of start to shoot up again and eventually hit the error for TD1 as lambda approaches 1. And so this is kind of the justification for why we want to consider TD lambda, that it's actually combining these two different sources of information, what happens at the end of an episode and what happens at each step, in a way that actually takes advantage of both, gets you the benefits of both. We're rapidly propagating information, and we're not getting a biased estimate because of the way that we're using one-step information. So it, it has some attractiveness to it.
Huh. Did you pick 0.7 on purpose? I remember reading a paper once that suggested that basically everyone uses lambda equals to 0.7.
I typically see, 0.3 to 0.7 as values where things tend to work out, where this bottom tends to fall. Somewhere between 0.3 and 0.7. Personally, I always use zero because it works better with control. I have had better performance and better understanding of what happens in the zero case. But it is true that if you actually run it with a finite amount of data, it tends to bottom out somewhere between 0.3 and 0.7.
Okay, that's worth knowing.
So that's actually all I wanted to tell you about TD Lambda. I wanted to give you a sense of how the equations are defined and how they're derived, and empirically why this is something that we actually care about. So maybe we should sum up.
Oh, I'm a big fan of sum. Is this going to be an infinite sum? Thank you. I've been here all week.